was in the month of June upon a Saturday afternoon, when me wife she called it to me without warning. She said, "Pat Quinlan, he just phoned you, looking for the twine he loaned you. Go haul your Caplin trap tomorrow morning." So 'twas take her off to collars for to make some extra dollars. I'm sure all hands agreed that that's quite charming. So with twine and rope and grapelin, we will catch the spawny Caplin to feed the Japanese on Sunday morning. 'Twas Loyola, Brendan, Larry, Ernan, Mose, and Tom, and Gary, all hands rushing in to bite, no time for yarning. There was Skipper Billy Pryor, scrabbling like a man of fire, just to be the first one in on Sunday morning. 'Twas Cliff and Robert Barter, 'twas a more than to starter, then go in around London's Point and head or northern. For the trap it lies in Swile Cove, and Cliff says to Bob, "Now by Jove, we'll put Caplin to the ringboat Sunday morning." 'Twas Fabian and Ronnie, Edmund Noon and brother Tommy, all in stippin' in the Caplin boys, they're swarming. Then Sim Lockyer turns to Johnny, says, "By most of them are spawny, we'll get 20 cents a pound on Sunday morning." Now we all thought we had less work, so we brought them to the breastwork. Then Ambrose called him out with all his learning. He said, "With undersize and red feet, boys, they're full of stuff we don't need. You'll get 2 cents a pound on Sunday morning. So don't make it a habit to go fishing on a Sabbath, 'cause the man above will take you without warning. And when you are 6 feet under, it's too late to know you blundered. You should have gone to Mass on Sunday morning. Yes, you should have gone to Mass on Sunday morning."